the last one to arrive is finally here. I hope you don't think you're special. It would be a shame if freedom went to your head. Or if you somehow got the idea you didn't need to pass your trials to become Sith. Lord Zash has tasked me with sorting through you refuse to find one worthy of being her apprentice, and I intend to do just that.
Who is this Zash?
That's Lord Zash to you, slave. She's a Dark Lord of the Sith and more important than you'll ever be. Now the rest of you gutter trash already know your trial. Get going while I bring our latecomer up to speed.
Watch your back, friend. And don't worry, it'll be all right. He can't kill us all.
Thanks. That means a lot coming from a beautiful girl.
You're cute. Just watch you don't get yourself killed.
Now, slave, for your trial. There's a hermit named Spindrol who lives in the tomb of Ajunta Paul in the Valley of the Dark Lords. Spindrol's a lunatic, but Lord Zash sees him as some kind of prophet. Once you find him, he will test you.
Fine. I will seek the insane hermit in the incredibly dangerous tomb and take his little test.
But there, you know your task. Spindrol lives in the tomb of Ajunta Paul in the Valley of the Dark Lords. Don't keep Spindrol waiting, slave.
Slave, welcome to my humble hole. You are here for your trial, yes? Learn the ways of the Sith from a doddering old man in a tomb, and hopefully to return to your master with the mark of my approval.
Actually, I just came to get some fresh air.
Do you take me for a fool? No one comes into these tombs for the sheer pleasure of it. Not even me. No, they come for power, because they sense that these tombs hold secrets of the dark side. And they do. But before you can learn them, you must pass a trial of blood. Survive this, and I will teach you what I know. Excellent. These former acolytes wanted nothing more than to earn their second chance for glory by killing you and taking your place. But your desire proved stronger, and their blood became the mantle of your victory. Well done. But you are not Sith yet. Peace is a lie. There is only passion. Through passion, I gain strength. Through strength, power. Through power, victory. Through victory, my chains are broken. This is the Sith Code. Commit it to your heart, and you will have the strength to crush your enemies. Do you understand?
Of course. I was born to be Sith.
Good. Then go. Return to Harkon and nurture your hatred for him. And use your fear of him to grow stronger. He may raise his fist to strike, but it is Lord Zash who determines where the blow will land.
But who controls Zash, I wonder?
When you know the answer to that, you will have power over both your masters. Now, go. Leave me to my rest.
past one. Always the latecomer. Now we can see what the Hermit thinks of you, Slime. Acolyte Corey. Step forward, please.
Yes, Overseer.
You are a weak, pathetic rodent, and even a lunatic like Spindrawl can see this. And that means... Meet our newcomer, Fon Alt. This is real Sith strength, and he will tear you apart and crush your bones, slaves. Look on him. No connections left in the world, but pure Sith blood. This is Lord Zash's future apprentice, not filth like you.
Nice to meet you, Fawn. Hope Harkon treats you better than he treats us.
Save your well wishes for someone who cares, slave.
Step this way, slave. I want to speak to you privately. The rest of you, get out of here. You know your trials. You too, Fon. Spindrawl awaits. Now, listen to me. Spindrawl is a lunatic. His approval means nothing. You are filth, and you will die. Is that clear?
You think you scare me?
You're nothing, and don't forget it. Now, your second trial. Lord Zash has requested a special trial for you, which you will no doubt fail. Go to Inquisitor Zinn in the jails. He will fill you in on the details, and most likely hasten your demise.
Don't count on my demise, Harkon. I don't die easily.
Don't boast, slave. I don't want to see you again until you're back from the jails. That's all.
Acolyte, you've arrived. And not a moment too soon. Harkon has given me very specific instructions. You were raised as a slave, but must discard those traits and learn to control others. And I have just the task for that end. Meet this driveling excuse for an acolyte. He will be your victim.
What exactly does this entail?
A short while ago, there was what we call an unauthorized murder here in the Academy. A rivalry among apprentices resulted in death. Interrogate him. Make him tell you who committed this crime at any cost.
I can absolutely do that.
Excellent. Get to it then. I look forward to watching you work.
Please, don't hurt me. I don't know anything.
Your defiance is foolish and misplaced.
Please, I don't know anything, I swear it. You know how it is. Acolytes start bragging. You don't want to look bad. It was just a dumb boast. I didn't see anything.
You're the only one who can bring the murderer to justice.
Justice? There is no justice in the Sith, just power. You can't help me. You can't protect me. Even if I did know something, I'd be dead. Or worse.
Sounds like you do know something.
What? No, I didn't mean... I've said too much. I can't tell you. He'll kill me.
Why not to make things worse?
I don't understand. Why threaten me with torture? Why not just get it over with?
My patience is wearing thin.
No, you misunderstand. It's just that any other acolyte would have used the machine by now. I'll tell you what I saw, but promise me that the murderer will get justice, that he won't come to kill me.
I'll do everything in my power.
As strange as it sounds coming from another acolyte, I appreciate that. An apprentice named Essor Kaen. I saw him murder his victim outside the library on the second floor. Listen, his master's incredibly powerful. He won't let Kaen be punished. Kaen will kill me.
You let me worry about that.
Thank you. I hope you know what you're doing.
You don't have to tell me. I heard the name loud and clear, though I sorely wish I hadn't. Essor Kaen. Kaen's master is a Dark Council member. I'd be a fool to oppose him. But anyway, your trial here is done. I will send my commendations to Overseer Harkon. You may return to him now.
What are you going to do about the murderer?
Nothing, although the apprentice's master will have to be informed. It's not my business to dispense justice, certainly not where the Dark Council is concerned.
If you don't make sure justice is served, Aelith will die.
Concern for matters that are not your business is a weakness that will get you killed. I suggest you eliminate this undesirable trait as quickly as possible and forget about this acolyte.
So you're just going to let yourself be bullied?
And what would you suggest? I don't have the power to oppose a Dark Council member, and neither do you.
That's not fear I smell, is it?
Well, I suppose it wouldn't hurt to keep him here while the master of the murdered apprentice pursues justice. Perhaps they can be made to believe that the acolyte hasn't been broken yet.
I don't care what you do. Just do it.
Fair enough. I'll requisition some guards to protect him. You have a most unusual approach, acolyte. Watch it doesn't get you into trouble.
Well, well, well. I had been looking forward to cutting another one of you down, but it looks like I'll be spared the trouble. Unsurprisingly, Nylock has gone missing. Also, unsurprisingly, Fon has passed his first trial. It's only a matter of time before he tramples you all underfoot.
I'll tear you apart where you stand, slave.
Patience, Fon. An accident in the tombs is much more convincing. Now the lot of you know your next task. Go. I want to speak to Fon and our latecomer. Now, slave. Zin says you handled yourself expertly, and as much as I find this difficult to believe, Lord Zash is satisfied with his evaluation. Undoubtedly, Zin helped you in some way, but you will not have his help on the next trial. Both you and Fon will have trials of intellect, trials that test your ability to apply your understanding of the Force to solve problems.
You don't expect a slave to be a match for me in intellect. I've been trained under the greatest teachers.
Calm down, Fon. I certainly do not expect this slave to be a match for you. That's why you will have separate trials.
Truly, your generosity astounds.
You're only digging your own grave. Fon, you will go to the library on the second floor of the Academy and translate the following texts for Lord Zash.
Yes, Overseer.
Slave, deep in the ancient, monster-infested tomb of Marka Ragnos, there is a holocron filled with dark secrets and encased in a great stone monument. No one has figured out how to release the holocron from its stone prison in over 1,000 years. You will bring this holocron to me, or you will die.
Well, it beats going to the library, I suppose.
Spoken like the idiot you are. You will bring back the holocron, or hope that the spirit of Marka Ragnos himself returns to end your miserable existence. Now go.
Fresh young acolyte, come to view my experiments. Good. I trust the sight of a messy operating table doesn't disturb you?
The path to power is not for the faint-hearted.
You remind me of myself at your age. This used to be a Tukata. The hound-like creatures infesting Korriban's tombs. On the surface, nothing special. But I alone can see this creature is an expression of pure dark side energy. Aggression made manifest.
Amazing. How did you learn that?
The Force told me so. It speaks to me. The Force is alive. It expresses its will in the physical world. This Tukata was one such form.
Are we another of these forms?
Sith are the highest manifestation of the Force's will. I've dissected hundreds of Tukata, forging a direct connection to the dark side. Each beast I examine advances me toward perfect unity. I now stand at a new frontier, but find myself thwarted. My most perfect specimen, a Tukata mutant, escaped to the tombs before I could analyze it.
Perhaps I could help you recover your specimen.
Yes, I was hoping as much. My apprentice, Melora, saw which tomb the mutant beast fled into. Find out what she knows, assist me, and you will be rewarded.
Why not send your apprentice to recover this beast?
She's more suited to the laboratory than the tombs. She lacks your fire, I'm afraid. Ask Melora where to seek the Tukata, and return to me when you have its brain.
Seeking Lord Renning's lost pet, are you? Don't waste your time. That fool's research is pointless.
Not a very loyal apprentice, are you?
He's my master in title only. He has nothing to teach anyone about the dark side of the Force. Renning deludes the Dark Council into believing he's advancing Sith knowledge. The truth is, he wastes the Empire's time and resources dissecting mindless animals. But if his experiments were discredited, he would be banished, and I would be rewarded.
Tell the Dark Council he's insane. I'm sure they'll listen.
Don't be naive. The Dark Council would never believe the word of an apprentice over her master. Look, just a minor alteration to the mutant Tukata's brain would allow me to reveal my master as a fraud. Bring me the brain before delivering it to Lord Renning, and I'll make it worth your while.
I'm sure there's some way we could work this out.
Perfect. Then we have an agreement. The mutant Tukata escaped to the tomb of Mark of Ragnos. It's much larger than the others, so it's easy to spot. Return to me with the brain before you see Lord Renning, and I'll take care of the rest.
I'm running out of patience. Have you finally acquired the mutant Tukata brain, or should I send someone else?
I got what you wanted.
Ha! Wonderful! Let me see it.
I hope you don't mind that the brain got a little scrambled.
I don't need it to be in pristine condition. Half the fun of my work is poking through the layers. You've done me a great service, but now I must continue my research. If there's nothing else?
Melora asked me to sabotage your experiment.
Is that so? Melora, if you can't show my work the appreciation it deserves, there's no place for you as my apprentice.
Wait, Master. It's a lie. I haven't betrayed you.
I know the truth when I hear it, Melora. I'm releasing you from my service.
Eventually.
Master, please. Stop! No!
My dear, the pain for you is only beginning. Take your reward and leave. Melora and I have much to discuss.
Show her some mercy. She doesn't have to die.
Oh, there are worse things than death. Goodbye, young one.
The power of the dark side is in me. Perhaps a little blood will satiate you.
Just open, damn it!
Better not be wasting my time, slave. You better have the holocron. A fake. Or stolen from the library, probably. I'll deal with you later. Now, I believe it's time for another demonstration. Gurr, step forward.
Yes, Overseer.
Fon, kill him.
With pleasure, Overseer.
Let Gurr be an example to you. Fon destroyed him easily, like he will destroy all of you. Are there any other objections?
You're heartless, Harkon. How can you be so cruel?
I am Sith. Something you will never be. Now the rest of you know the next trial. Go. You, slave, Stay here. Now, slave, you think yourself pretty clever getting that holocron, don't you?
I really am the best.
You are lucky Lord Zash finds you useful. Now for your trial. The last, darkest secrets of Tulak Horde are buried in his tomb. Lord Zash wants this text. But the final resting place of the dead lord is not easily trespassed. You will not be the first to die there.
Yes, yes, yes. You send me into a tomb to do the impossible, hoping I die, and I come back and prove you wrong.
Shut up, slave! I've had about enough of your mockery. Do not come back here until you've gotten the text from Tulak Horde's tomb. Out of my sight, slave!
Remarkable. Magnificent.
You slave. What? No, acolyte. You're the one who brought me this magnificent holocron from the tomb of Marco Ragnos, yes?
Yes, my lord. I found the holocron.
Unbelievable. 1,000 years buried in that tomb, the Sith lords passing it by. And then the most unlikely person comes along. Tell me, how did you manage it?
I shot lightning at it and it opened.
Such a simple solution. Why did none of us think of that? We must have thought too deeply on it, believed too strongly that it could not be done. Or perhaps we were simply not meant to open it. Your work so far, in bringing back this holocron and now the text from Tulak Horde's tomb, has me intrigued. I am watching your progress eagerly. I have high hopes for you, acolyte. Sky high.
Really? Harkon seems to favor Fawn.
Harkon's only purpose is to weed out the weak. Beyond that, his opinion means nothing. Good luck, acolyte. Good luck.
I was just about to send Fawn off. What delayed you, slave?
Well, First Lord Zash stopped me to tell me how amazing I am. And then we got talking. And I suppose I lost track of time.
Just like a slave to make up stories. Lord Zash would crush you like a Gizkar if you ever crossed her path. You're not worthy of her presence. Now, did you collect the text from Tulak Horde's tomb?
Of course. As always, I'm brilliant.
Give it here. No doubt it's been badly damaged. It's what we get for sending a careless lowlife to do a Sith job. Isn't that right, Fawn?
What are we waiting for, Overseer? Why don't we kill this wretch now?
You have a big mouth, slave, but no combat skills. I don't want to see you again until you've satisfied the Korriban instructors. The training facility is on the second floor of the academy and is usually reserved for the Dark Lords and their apprentices. This is not a promotion, and you are not to speak to anyone except the training master when you are up there, understand? You are not fit for their presence.
Please tell me Fawn can come. We'll have so much fun.
Fawn has been training at combat his whole life. He was born to be Sith. You are just as likely to chop your own arm off as not, slave. Now get going to the second floor training grounds. You don't want to keep the instructors waiting.
Hello there, friend. You remember my brother and me from downstairs? With Harkon, right?
Sorry it had to be this way.
We don't like it any more than you do. Well, maybe a little more.
This sounds vaguely like a threat. What did I ever do to you?
I'm sorry, man. I liked you. I really did.
But Harkon made us a deal, see? We kill you, we go home.
You will regret that.
We don't want to. But we know we can't beat Fawn. And we'll never be Sith. At least this way we can go home, alive.
Quiet, Baelic. The time for talk is past. Fight for your life, Acolyte.
Well, well. Look who shows up at long last. I half expected to hear you'd crossed some dark lord upstairs and finally got yourself killed. None of the others have shown up either. I assume they're dead by now, which means you and Fawn are the last ones.
Speaking of Fawn, he seems conspicuously absent.
You only wish it, slave. No. You took so long returning, I sent Fawn ahead. Your final trial will be to retrieve an ancient map from the innermost chamber of Naga Sado's tomb, which has never been breached in thousands of years. But before you get the map, you'll have to awaken an ancient assassin called a Dashard that sleeps in the tomb. You cannot access the map without him. Understand?
What exactly is a Dashard?
They're a lost race of assassins that the ancient Sith used to devour their force-using enemies. This one'll probably eat you the moment he's freed. Oh, and one more thing. You'll be competing with Fawn for this map. Whoever brings it back will be Lord Zash's apprentice. The other will die. And Fawn's already started, so my advice? Run, slave. Run.
One moment, please.
Lord Zash! What are you doing here?
Overseer, are you implying that I, a Lord of the Sith, don't have the right to go where I please within the Academy of the Sith?
No. Of course not, Lord Zash.
Good. I saw the last acolyte arrive. I wanted to see the hopefuls off on their final trial. Where's, the red one, Fawn?
He finished his trial early, so I sent him on rather than keeping him waiting for this.
Pity. I just finished translating the wonderful text this acolyte brought from Tulak Horde's tomb, and it's most illuminating. I don't know that the map can be retrieved without it.
Well, well, well. It's a good thing I didn't start running, isn't it, Harkon?
It's too late. Fawn's already left. You can't just...
Give one acolyte an unfair advantage over the other? Overseer, when has being Sith ever been about being fair? Now, my dear acolyte, here is what you must do to free the Dashard. There are rods scattered throughout the tomb of Naga Sado. These rods are the keys to the chamber where the ancient assassin is imprisoned. You will need to place the rods in the chamber door and electrify them. I don't know exactly the reason, but it is clear that you will not be able to retrieve the map without the Dashard. But be careful. He is very dangerous.
Is there anything else I should know about the Dashard?
It's a force-resistant assassin. I have reason to believe this one was placed in the tomb by Tulak Horde himself. I will return when both acolytes are back from the tomb. You will not do anything further to affect the outcome of the trial. Understood?
Yes, Lord Zash.
Good. And good luck, acolyte.
Isis Amin's Waihai's fools. Gawendida seek from Tauhans. Itaukida melaswesama word sign in Meremnai Saigatrawa Dedal. Chagasar Chais embarks prize war perem swase ik bus karadida.
These were the instructions Zash gave me. I am to free you, and you will take me to the map in the final chamber of the tomb.
Ababarna Habens, Glaubbena, Ni in Usakwai, Usiterens Apipao. Was Jabe, Wise Jabe, Prophetess, Wisans Jagara Haitang.
I hate to be the one to break it to you, but Tulak Horde is dead.
He places Amin's Waihai's fools. Gawendida seek from Tauhans. Paprogatua, Ina in Lausolam. Jagasatida du ima. Twade in Warpai and Parlaikain. Name in maidens. Ipsik by Kudana, Jaus by Rojandan, in Bise Wistai. In Bizose Waitai Spila Presin Kretai, in Bise Ewanata, Patragata Injais.
I am your master. Get used to it.
Sisunja, Targi Skolan.
I'm telling you, Overseer, it cannot be done. I went into the tomb, I saw the Dashard across the chasm, but I could not get to it.
But the map, the map! Lord Zash is adamant she will not take an apprentice without the map!
I'm telling you, Lord Zash wants the impossible. No one is ever going to get that map!
You don't mean this map, do you?
The map, and the Dashard! Get that monster out of here this instant! And give me the map!
No, it's not possible. You wretch, you filth, you must have cheated somehow. How did you do it? How did you release the monster?
Sai Galut Saida, Iswis Us Ulfbundan, Ja Atnam, In Puidangarja.
Right. You must have cheated. You must have. You'll pay for this!
Fawn, patience. You will have your chance at this whelp after you personally deliver this map to Lord Zash.
Eat them both, Kem.
Dobila Wesun.
Keep your pet at bay for just a moment, Acolyte. I would have a word with Fon.
Lord Zash?
Yes, Fon. Now, where's my map?
Here, Lord Zash. Right here.
You found it for me, Fon? How wonderful.
He couldn't have found it if he tried.
Silence! Fon will tell me what happened, won't you, Fon? You wouldn't dare lie to me, would you? Because it would be a shame for me to discover that you lied to me. Now, one more time. Did you bring this map back from Nagasado's tomb?
No, I didn't. I'm sorry.
Hearken, you fool. In any other group for any other lord, this young man would have torn the other acolytes to shreds. What were you trying to prove? That you could outsmart me? That you knew better than me what kind of person I wanted for an apprentice? You fool! There's your pet, Hearken. Clean this mess up. Apprentice, meet me in my chambers upstairs.
As you say.
This is not the end.
Without Lord Zash to save you, you're nothing. I have connections that will hunt you wherever you go.
I'm sorry it turned out this way, Harkon. I know you never liked me much, but I learned a lot from you.
What? Well, I guess it is an overseer's job to inspire his charges. Now get going, slave. I mean, apprentice.
My magnificent new apprentice. Congratulations are in order, I believe.
Thank you for giving me this opportunity.
You've earned it, my apprentice. Now, I was just looking over this astonishing map you brought back, and I can tell we have a lot of work ahead of us.
What is this map of, exactly?
We can't talk about it here. Too many unfriendly ears. You must meet me on Dromund Kaas. There we can talk more.
Dromund Kaas. Got it.
I will meet you in my chambers in the Citadel in Kaas City. There we can speak more freely of the work ahead, without the fear of unfriendly ears. This is the lightsaber I had as an apprentice. I want you to have it.
I am honored.
Excellent. I'm glad you like it. It served me well. Now, remember, my chambers, the Citadel, Dromund Kaas. It's imperative that we get to work on this as soon as possible.
Stop right there, slave. Darth Scotia has a message for you.
Who is this Darth Scotia?
Darth Scotia is Lord Zash's superior, and your worst nightmare. The message is this. You will not go to Dromund Kaas. Everything you've done here, everyone you've dealt with, Lord Zash included, is insignificant. Darth Scotia has eyes and ears on Korriban. He knows what your master is up to, and he is displeased, to say the least. On Korriban, Lord Zash may have her way, but on Dromund Kaas, it's a different story. So you see, you have to die.
Kem, what is it you do to Force users again?
Gibai Iswis Aman Hanguijins.
Ortosin, is that a Dashard? Maybe this isn't such a good idea.
Coward! Fight, you fool!
Oh.